The Supercar Challenge is powered by Pirelli, Autosportinsurance.com, Syntix Innovative Lubricants, Magler, create your own digital magazine, and Valero, FIA approved race and rally base layers. Welcome to the Supercar Challenge powered by Pirelli. It's the fifth round of the championship, and for the first time this season, the GTs, touring cars and sports cars start on Dutch soil at the TT Circuit of Assen. The weekend turned out to be a real game changer in the championship. At Assen, those who were out of luck in the previous rounds picked up valuable points and are back in the running for the title. We'll show you how it all transpired in the Supercar Challenge powered by Pirelli. Traditionally, the first round in Assen is held at the Gamma Racing Day, the largest combined karting, bike and car racing event in the Netherlands. And this always means packed grandstands, spectacular demos and, of course, the racing of the Supercar Challenge powered by Pirelli. So we'll kick off our action with two races for the Supersport and Sport classes. Pole position for race one in Supersport goes to the Lotus Exige drivers Jan van der Kooi and Priscilla Spelman. They share the front row with the winners of the first race in Zolder, Marcel van der Maart and Peter Schroyers. Lining up third with the Seat Leon Cup racer is Dennis de Borst, the championship leader. This weekend he shares with Pim van Riet, and he starts alongside the BMW Z4 GTR of Erik van der Munkhoff, who currently lies fourth in the championship, 26 points adrift. Second in the points is Robert Vandenberg, but he's unable to start because of engine problems with his BMW, so Dan Meyer is alone on the third row. Behind him, the third place pair in the championship, Ronald and Luke Van Loon, line up seventh, eager for a good result after the crash at Zolder that cost them the championship lead, while in eighth place is Dennis Heuveling with the second Ferry Monster Autosport Seat Leon. Pole for the third time this season in the sport class is in the hands of Piet de Jong and starting driver Carleen Bergsma. Their Lotus Exige is ahead of championship leaders Bart Drost and Niels Kuhl with the BMW 135i. After four poles in a row, they start second. They share the points lead with Belgians Bart van der Broek and Chris Voet in the Peugeot RCZ. They scored poorly in Zolder and lie a disappointing sixth after qualifying. Saturday's first race is held in scorching conditions, 34 degrees of track temperature, and it's a 45-minute encounter rather than the normal 60. Ronald van Loon keeping the gap in front of him where Robert Vandenberg should be. Safety car pulls in. Row two in front, and then it's Dan Meyer alongside the gap. Van Loon in that gap at the moment, shouldn't be. As the leaders get ready to start, red lights are on, and Dan Meyer's already going alongside Erik van der Munkhoff. He hasn't really allowed the gap in front. Through he goes, though. It's Priscilla Spelman who leads, three wide behind. Erik van der Munkhoff in the middle of it all. But Dan Meyer bumps his way by Pim van Riet. The white BMW is up to third. The orange BMW, Marcel van der Maart, second. Priscilla Spelman leads. Erik van der Munkhoff in fifth, right in front of us. Pim van Riet, Seat, just a little wide after contact with Dan Meyer and contact with van der Munkhoff as well. Up to the sharp left-hander now, it's Strubben. Oh, contact, Pim van Riet hits Dan Meyer on the inside. Through goes van der Munkhoff, three wide. Bumping, and BMWs are both off. Looks like the Seat's damaged. Ronald van Loon up to third, but two very badly damaged BMWs in the barriers. Well, bumping and banging all the way into Strubben. The Seat then the meat in the sandwich here as they bounce off each other. It did not end well for van der Munkhoff or for Meyer. And Pim van Riet also pulling off. Well, luckily all three drivers were uninjured, but I'm not sure they all saw it the same way.
Zoals je gezien hebt, rijdt een keer wijd. Geef meneer van der Munkhoff een beuk.
Everyone could see Pim ran wide, bumped into Erik van der Munkhoff, then he ran into me at the next corner, and then all three of us collided. Erik and I crashed hard into the barriers, really very unnecessary. Two heavily damaged cars, three broken cars. Car was over in the first lap, really a shame. Not just the damage, but potentially a fun race down the drain. Unfortunately, we all escaped injury, but it was very scary. Next time, I think I'll just take it easy, start all over again. That's all we can do. The good news is, JR Motorsport said they can fix the car. We'll be ready to race tomorrow, so Sunday, hopefully, we'll get to race again.
Nee, rechts van mij zat Munkhoff, die reed met mij mee. and ik was wat vergeten, want ik had...
Eric was next to me and I was unbalanced after getting hit in the first and second turns. Made an error, I braked on the curbs, I bumped into the car in front of me, but we all survived these little incidents. But because we were so close together, our wheels touched and then everything went from bad to worse. Well, of course, it's the start of the race, so everybody's trying to find a little advantage. Maybe get it in front of the guys in front of you if they make mistakes or they're battling each other. Should I have given them more room? Well, if I'd known this was going to happen, I would never have dared to try and get close and overtake them. Weird situation, really. I guess Dan Meyer and Pim van Riet weren't giving each other a millimetre of room. They were very frustrated, and ultimately, I paid the price. 20 minutes of safety car in a 45-minute race as they restart. Priscilla Spellman leading Marcel van der Maart, and behind Hank Tappel in the 1 Series BMW ahead of the Lotus of Carleen Bergsma, who'd led early on. On board with Bart van den Broek. This is the battle with Bart Drost for fourth position. Drost dropped down from second at the start. Red car in front, that is Kim Troyen, who had a good opening lap. Around the outside comes the Peugeot. This is a battle the championship leaders can ill afford to lose. Oh, a spin! Kim Troyen going to block the road. And Bart van der Broek losing three places there, down to sixth position. Battle for the lead of the class. Priscilla Spellman ahead of Marcel van der Maart. And third place, Ronald van Loon's BMW ahead of the Seat of Dennis Heuveling. Heuveling having a run on the inside. Can't quite squeeze through there. But the podium spots are up for grabs. Marcel van der Maart now with the Lotus back in front. Priscilla Spellman's nimble Lotus versus the power of the BMW. Van der Maart with his nose on the inside. This is the long right-hander, Van Deffen. And Ronald van Loon in third position, showing that the BMW has got by the Lotus as they sweep through Ramshoek towards the end of the lap. Van Loon trying to look around the outside as well. Into the gate, Timmer Chicane. Priscilla Spellman controls the line. And here comes Dennis Heuveling in the Seat. He's looking for a podium finish. Marcel van der Maart trying to clear off in the orange BMW. Priscilla Spellman second. Ronald van Loon still third. But Dennis Heuveling looking to the inside into Harbocht. Can't quite squeeze through. Oh, mistake by van Loon in the BMW. And Dennis Heuveling now running out wide, but with an opportunity perhaps. And van Loon really struggling. He's got a problem. It's a puncture, left rear tyre. And the father and son could have had a big point score here with the podium. This all dropped them down the order, but they need to finish. And they're also going to get a drive-through penalty. Luke had to come in with a puncture, change the left rear. To make things worse, we came in for a drive-through as well. Not sure why, might have been too short a pit stop. We came in too early, don't know, but it's a shame. There's no way we're going to end up on the podium today, though. Priscilla Spellman and Jan van der Kooi won the 45-minute race despite five result seconds, 5 seconds ahead of Dennis Heuveling. First race win of the season for the Lotus duo after technical problems in most of the other encounters. This time pole fastest lap and first to the flag. And that's a big relief for the two of them. Shame that big crash happened on the opening lap, says Jan. That took out three of our rivals that could have made life difficult for us, but I think we might still have won it. We're the best today. Fastest in qualifying in the rain. Today we had the fastest lap time in the race as well. Priscilla did a great job in the first stint. Too bad it was mostly under the safety car, but in a few laps remaining she kept the lead for a long time, set the fastest sector time, so an excellent job, and all I had to do was finish the race. Back to the sport class, before the pit stops, Bart Drost getting ahead of the Lotus of Carleen Bergsma for second place. Ruud Olly right behind, a guest driver in the Supersport class in 344, stuck in the middle of this sport class traffic. Leader in sport class, Hank Tappel in the BMW 1 Series, pulling away fast. On board with Bart van den Broek, joint championship leader. Chasing Marcel Dekker in front, and in front of him, Stan van Oord. And these are a couple of the Clios that got by when he got held up by the spinner early on. Carleen Bergsma struggling with the Lotus. She's dropping fast down the order. They are queuing up to go by her. And it seems that the team thinks she has alternator problems. Well, the Spirit Racing team with Stan van Oord in the Clio leading after the pit stops. Rob Neiman in second place. Neiman losing that to Harold Vesseling's BMW 1 Series. And Wesseling charging on board with Stan Van Oord in the closing stages. Through goes Wesseling, but Van Oord not to be outdone, fighting back. And this is nip and tuck. Van Oord with damage chattering away, the splitter at the front of the car. But it doesn't seem to be putting him off too much. And clearly the Clio still has the pace. And on this long, fast Assen circuit, you can see the Supersport BMW of Ronald and Loke van Loon behind can't get by. These two sport cars are flying. Rob Neiman in the back of this queue, but this is all about Stan Van Oord. The battle for victory. Will it be the BMW? Will it be the Renault? Van Oord checking his mirrors. Van Loon finally getting by on the straight. And will he clear both of them? Yes, just about. Oh, but Wesseling has to turn in a little tighter than he'd want to. In too deep. He goes out wide. Stan Van Oord has the lead on the final lap. The checkered flag awaits. It'll be the first win of the year for the Clio driver. Also drivers Bart van den Broek and Chris Voet finished only 7th. That means with Niels Kuhl and Bart Jos taking 3rd, they also have the lead of the sport class title race. But the happiest man is Stan Van Oord.
Ja, dat voelt echt super. We hebben er,
so great. We've been trying to win a race for the last 4 weekends and we've been so close. Finally, here it is. Team's been working so hard every weekend. It wasn't easy. We had a long safety car, not what we hoped for. It's a short race, but competition is really tough here. But I managed to keep him behind me. It was an insane race. I'm really happy. Race 2 on Sunday is a regular 16-minute encounter. The set of Dennis de Borst and Pim van Riet has been repaired and they'll start 2nd on the grid. Erik van der Munkos' BMW is a write-off though, but he's been invited by Dan Meyer to join him in the race. Dan Meyer doing the first stint in the blue and white BMW. Priscilla Spellman on pole again, ahead of Dennis de Borst, the Lotus and the Seat on row 1. Peter Scheuer's in 3rd, no Robert Vandenberg 4th. So Dan Meyer in 5th, Ronald van Loon alongside in 6th. And we're on board with van Loon on the outside of the 3rd row of the grid. Gap in front gives him a good run down on the outside. But it is again Priscilla Spellman who leads. Seat to Dennis de Borst in 2nd place. Van Loon going around the outside. Everybody being understandably a little cautious this time, a little more cautious at least. Karleen Bergsma's Lotus also on pole ahead of Bart Jos BMW 135, but that's already got up into the sport class lead. There he is. White Lotus of Karleen Bergsma behind. Blue and black Renault Clio of our race one winner. That's Stan Van Oord in 3rd from 5th on the grid. 4th place is Chris Voet in the Peugeot RCZ, but there's trouble for him. Look, Wesseling knocks a tyre stack into the road. Voet can't avoid it. Luckily, only minor damage to the former championship leaders. Here's our race lead. Priscilla Spellman, the black and gold Lotus. Then Dennis de Borst right behind her, the Seat Leon Cup racer. Didn't get to drive in the first race when the car was wrecked. Pim van Riet starting it. Now he is all over Priscilla Spellman, the race one winner. Determined to try and get a hat full of points here. The race victory, Dennis Heuveling on the back of the queue. And Dennis de Borst is really piling the pressure on the Lotus driver. Out the Steckenval, got a good run going. Next is a left-hander at De Bult, hard on the brakes, down the inside, takes the corner and takes the lead. And behind there was a change for 3rd happening. Yes, Peter Scheuer's ahead of Ronald van Loon. So Dennis de Borst leads, Priscilla Spellman, Peter Scheuer's in 3rd, Van Loon in 4th position, Meyer in 5th and Heuveling in 6th place. And Dan Meyer's got a good run going on the X-World Touring Car BMW. Goes by Ronald van Loon and here comes Dennis Heuveling as well. He's going to challenge van Loon for 5th place. Heuveling been on the back of the queue for the last few laps. Now he's looking for a way around the outside. Has the BMW got a problem? Dennis Heuveling just drives right by him. Rob Neiman being helped out of his car, looking a little shaken after a big crash in front of the main grandstands. Big crowd glad to see that he's all right. Well, what happened here? Well, look at this. A major moment for the Clio driver after collision with Wim Lemmers. On board, there's Lemmers right in front. through the gate to the chicane, and suddenly he stops, and Rob Neiman not able to react in time, and that's a big crash.
Ik heb net de engineer gesproken van het andere team.
Heavily damaged, Clio. Had a quick chat with the engineer from the other team, says Rob. He told me their car just stopped dead after the fuel pump died. And when that happened, I was really close behind him. He moved right, our wheels collided, my car was just launched into the air. It started rolling and I slid along the side in front of the grandstand. Long slide, and then the car finally fell back onto its wheels and I bumped into the wall. It's a sad end to the weekend, though. Battle for second. Priscilla Spellman in the Lotus ahead of the orange BMW of Peter Scheuers. And Dan Meyer in an identical M3 GTR 3.2 right behind. The speed of the BMW pays. Down into the gate, Timo Chicane. He goes through into second, but there are problems in the Lotus camp. The alternator connector and battery cable broke. There was no charging, so everything electronic started to pack up. Priscilla got towed back to the pit lane so we could weld a new connector onto the cable. She's back out again, and hopefully we'll complete 75% race distance to score some points.
We're on the road again. Yeah,
it's really frustrating that a 25-cent piece has put an end to a potentially good result. We had great pace, but some of the others are having trouble too, so let's see what happens. It's going to be close. We need points for the championship. Every point counts. Some of the rivals are indeed having problems. Dennis de Borst losing the lead to Peter Scheuers as the Seat strikes engine problems, and he loses a few more spots up to the mandatory pit stops where the team starts hunting the problem. Seem to have an issue with the fuel sensor, says Dennis. It's a shame, because when you're driving, the engine just stalls. Impossible to keep the lead. I lost a few more places before the pit stop. Unfortunately, the team couldn't fix the problem, so we're just going to have to carry on and make the most of it. All is not lost, though. With the problems for all their rivals, they still finish in second place. Peter Scheuers is out. He finished third on Saturday, won one race at Zolder on the Saturday, but again, bad luck on the Sunday.
Het ging super goed. Dus ik had een plekje verloren bij de start.
Everything was perfect in the opening stages. I lost a place from the start. I fought my way back though to take the lead. And then suddenly the engine temperature started rising rapidly. It went sky high, so I had to shut off the engine. Temperature dropped instantly, so I tried to cruise back to the pit lane, but it seems the belt snapped, and unfortunately we can't fix that here. Well, that's good news for Dan Meyer. He took the lead before the pit stops and then handed over to Erik van der Munkhoff. Van der Munkhoff, new to this car, of course, has never driven even a single lap with this BMW. Dan Meyer feeling confident, though. First place, pedal to the metal, he says. Neither Erik van der Munkhoff or Dan Meyer finished race one. Therefore, they have no additional result seconds. But with no practice at all in the BMW, van der Munkhoff has Pim van Riet on his tail. And unused to the car, eventually he cracks under pressure. He then has problems getting back on track and loses a lap to the leader. And that's not going to be Luc Van Loon, who has a puncture again on the left rear. Dennis Heuveling, with 15 result seconds, is the only one not to hit trouble. He wins his first ever race in Supersport. Not the easiest of wins despite a huge margin, because Pim van Riet was closing in fast. But with the ongoing engine problems, van Riet lost touch with Heuveling. Despite their puncture, the Van Loons took third behind a Seat 1-2 with Dennis Heuveling on top of the pile, but it didn't come easy.
Yeah.
Quite nerve-wracking near the end. The second place car was closing in fast. Luckily, the gap was big enough to keep the lead. I'm happy it all worked out, because instead of just racing, I had to work out how many laps I had left, what lap time I had to do. But I knew if I made no mistakes, it should be okay. And so I won. Dennis de Borst and Martin de Klein couldn't do this round, but they are still the championship leaders, although now they share with Ronald and Luc Van Loon. Dennis Heuveling now just 5 points adrift. Early leader in the sport class is Harald Wesselink in the BMW 1 Series. Here's the battle for second place. Race 1 winner Stan Van Oord in the Renault Clio all over Carleen Bergsma, whose Lotus started on pole position. And a battle of very different cars. Front engine, front wheel drive, production hatchback versus mid-engine, rear wheel drive, lightweight sports car. And Van Oord gets his nose in front, but Carleen Bergsma enjoys a wheel-to-wheel battle and comes right back at him into the get. Timmer Chicane sneaking back into second. Chris Foote and Bart Vandenbroek not far behind in the Peugeot RCZ. The Lotus leads off the pit stops with the early leading BMW, now with Henk Teppel up in second place. Bart Vandenbroek in third, then this battle. Marcel Dekker in the Clio ahead of Niels Kuhlen. Bart Drost in the BMW 135. Stan Van Oord down to sixth position, courtesy of his result seconds. Niels Kuhl taking fourth place on the Feinslang. Marcel Dekker's Clio down to fifth position. But again, two very different machines. The Clio keeps the pace up, trying to go back around the outside. Sharing with Jos Veldboer. And it's wheel-to-wheel action all the way. The Renault Clio and the BMW 1 Series battling just off the podium. The checkered flag finally comes out for Peder de Jong as he and Carleen Bergsma win their first race of the season. Harald Wesselink unable to claim his third Gamma Racing Day win in a row. So the Lotus on top of the pile, finally avoiding problems.
Nah, yeah, it was wel hard werken. It ging,
might look easy, but it was really hard. So Peter, everything went well. In the first half of the race, we were second, so we had a bit of work to do. After the pit stops, though, I was all alone. My task to bring the car home. Really happy that everything worked out well. Great feeling. Bart Drost and Niels Kuhl extend their lead in the sport class, but Chris Foote and Bart Vandenbroek minimise the damage by finishing ahead of them in the second race. Coming up, full reports on both races for Super GT, GTB and the Superlights divisions. The Supercar Challenge is powered by Pirelli, autosportinsurance.com, Syntix Innovative Lubricants, Magler, create your own digital magazine, and Valero, FIA-approved race and rally base layers. Welcome back to the Supercar Challenge powered by Pirelli at the TT Circuit of Assen for the fifth race weekend. Time to take a look at the action in Super GT, GTB and Superlights. Costa Canaroglu and Oliver Campos-Hull are not here. And with the Super GT Championship points leaders absent, their rivals will likely take advantage. A large combined grid with the Superlights at the front, pole position claimed by Tim Joensen in the Deldish Racing Norma. Next to him, Jan Lammers in the Davy Tech Ligier, which has been promoted to the highest category on the basis of its pace. The first Super GT lines up on the second row, and that's Henry Zumbrink with the Volvo S60 V8 that scored 0 points after engine problems in the previous round at Zolder. And the same tale of woe applies to the driver next to him. That's Henk Thijs with the Pumax RT. The 72-year-old former champion is slowly becoming really competitive with his new project. On row three, Martin Lanting is back in a Ferrari 458 GTE as a guest driver. Next to him is Pedro Salvador in the only present E2P Racing Mosler. He and Alberto Di Martin will now most likely take over the championship lead in Super GTs. In GTB, Chris Matthews and Vard Slice start from pole for the sixth time this season with the BMW M4 Silhouette. A total of 27 cars started in the bumper field for the first 45-minute race of the weekend, 15 minutes shorter than usual, so result seconds will have a greater influence on the outcome. Well, it's a hot day, 34 degrees of track temperature as Tim Joensen heads the field away. Yellow car Jan Lammers alongside, then Henry Zumbrink and Henk Thijs, Martin Lanting, Pedro Salvador. Into the gate, Timmer Chicane for the final time. Tim Joensen with the red and white, the Norma, On pole position ahead of Jan Lammers and Henry Tumbrink in third. Here we go, lights change and the 2-litre Honda engine in the Norma outgunned by the Ligier and by the V8 in the Volvo. But it's Jan Lammers that takes the lead in the yellow Ligier. And it looked as though Tim Joensen was using the aero to try and go around the outside. Marcel van Berlo in front of us as we ride with Mark van der Aar. Dark Porsche in front is Roger Graus, and in front of him Chris Matthews leading GTB. Jan Lammers leads with the yellow and white Ligier, red and white Tim Joensen trying to come underneath him. Looking back for the GTB leader, there's the white BMW, the Porsche underneath. Roger Graus has gone by to take the lead. Still in fourth place with Mark van der Aar. Marcel van Berlo right in front, and then Chris Matthews, the white car. So Roger Graus has indeed got by. That's him, the very next car up the road, chasing two of the super lights, and Chris Matthews loses another place. Matthews down to third place now in GTB, and under pressure from Mark van der Aar, entertaining first lap. Jan Lammers leads from Tim Joensen, Henry Tumbrink and Henk Tace third and fourth, ahead of Pedro Salvador in the Mosler. He's got ahead of Martin Lanting's Ferrari. Battle for the lead in Super GT, on board in second place with Henk Tace. There's Henry Tumbrink, the leader, right in front, but Tumbrink is starting to lose pace, and here comes the Pumax driver around the outside, up to third overall. Tumbrink struggling in the Volvo, more engine problems. Jan Lammers leading most of the first part of the race. Tim Joensen right on his tail in the little Norma. Lammers with 25 result seconds, 30 less than Tim Joensen and Luc de Kock, so this should work out well for the Dutch veteran. Joensen and Luc de Kock have dominated Group 1 of Superlight so far with three wins. Fritz van Aert takes over from Jan Lammers, who lost the lead just before the pit stops. But he's had a good battle and gives Fritz van Aert every chance to go out and win the race.
Yeah, start ging allemaal goed and auto was verder prima. Toen met het verkeer dan moet je wat vaker van je lijn af, dus dan worden je banden.
Start was fine, car's great. All the traffic after a few laps, you have to go offline and pick up a bit of dirt. Caused me a few problems. The car started to slide, so Tim Joensen took advantage, got by me, picked the perfect moment. So he's quicker in the slow parts of the track, but that made for a fun race. I think we've still got a chance to win the race. Let's see how it goes.
Fantastic.
Looks like Tim Joensen has enjoyed himself just as much. Fantastic, he said. Great fun. It was an honour to be in first place on the grid next to a legend like Jan Lammers. And to spend a complete stint in a battle with Jan, even greater. I had a great time in the car. I don't think this gets any more fun. With zero result seconds, Henk Tace takes the overall lead, but inevitably Fritz van Aert catches him in the Ligier and passes him in Strubben. Of course, Henk still has the lead in Super GT. On the last lap, Nigel Melker, who's in the other Ligier, which was started by Milan Doncha, closes on Fritz van Aert, and in the very final corner, he gets by him. Fritz thinks he's lost the race then to his teammate, but Melker and Doncha have a time penalty for not taking a drive-through, so who is the winner? Well, Fritz is confused. I've got no idea if I just won or lost the race. I don't know what happened. Didn't Nigel pass me in the last corner? No, really? Well, that's what I thought happened. Oh, so that means I've won the race. Great news. You're kidding me. Hey, guys, we won it. It's a first race win for Fritz van Aert and Jan Lammers together in the Supercar Challenge. They finished on the podium, of course, last time out at Spa. Looks like a good call to put the LMP3 Ligiers in the Superlights class. Tim Joensen and Luc de Kock still finished second, with Wolf GB08 drivers Rolf Kampers and Leon Rijnbeck in third. Winner in Group 2 Superlights Challenge, Dominic Gierkes, with Fiona James driving the Praga R1 into second place. Into the closing stages, the battle for second in Super GT. Henry Tumbrink in the Volvo just ahead of 104. Bob Herbert in the Mercedes SLS AMG. Henk Tace leading in Super GT, but in the final corner, Tumbrink gets a little out of shape and Bob Herbert goes around him in the gear Timmer chicane to grab second place at the line. On board with Henry, locks up down the gearbox. That's all he can do to make the chicane. Bob Herbert just finds enough room to squeeze past. Henk Tace, the sprightliest 72-year-old you'll see at any racetrack, wins by 44 seconds in the Puma XRT. And the gap between second and third, 44 hundredths of a second. Bob Herbert to Henry Zumbrink. With fifth place in race one, Alberto Di Martino and Pedro Salvador do take the lead in Super GT, but it is by the tiniest of margins. Mark van der Aar loses third place in GTB after a steering arm failure, and that puts him off in the gravel. Nothing he can do about it. The car just refuses to turn left halfway around Strubben, and he's off in the gravel trap. Well, that's a great opportunity for arch rival Roger Graz, who is leading the race before the pit stops. But with 55 result seconds, 35 more than Vard Slice and Chris Matthews, Graz really needs his rivals to hit problems. But instead, it all goes wrong for him.
Het ging eigenlijk heel voortreffelijk, ja. Alleen de watertemperatuur liep wat hoger.
Everything was going great, says Roger. Suddenly the water temperature started rising and went way up where it might damage the engine. I'm really looking forward to racing tomorrow as well, so I prefer that the team check the problem out now rather than not race tomorrow. So safer to stop now. With just 5 result seconds, Marcel van Berlo took the lead but lost it again after a drive-through penalty. Such a shame, he said. Really hate that. Another pit stop too short, just a second or less. Shouldn't have happened. So maybe Jos Janssen then. 0 result seconds, but also 0 luck. Trapped in the gravel at Strubben. So it is another win for Chris Matthews and Vard Slice, their fourth of the season from 7 races. I have to say, Chris did an amazing job. Great first stint. We couldn't take the lead before the pit stops, but that meant I had my work cut out for me. I had a long battle with our Turkish friends, and then we lost the leaders. But that's part of racing as well, so I'm happy that we still finished first. Coming up, a full report on race 2 for Super GT, GTB and Super Lights, where not everything went according to plan. The Supercar Challenge is powered by Pirelli, Autosportinsurance.com, Syntix Innovative Lubricants, Magler, create your own digital magazine, and Valero, FIA-approved race and rally base layers. Welcome back to the Supercar Challenge, powered by Pirelli at the TT Circuit of Assen for the fifth round of the championship. And Dutch racing legend Jan Lammers is preparing for the second race of the weekend, starting from the front row of the grid. With the other Davy Tech Engineering Ligier LMP3, Milan Doncic will start from the last row after being hit in practice and failing to make qualifying. But 72-year-old Henk Tace will be eager to win again in Super GT in race 2. Same too for Henry Zumbrink. He won race 2 of the Gamma Racing Day last year. He finished 3rd in race 1. Our new championship leaders are Pedro Salvador and Alberto Di Martin waving there at the camera. With 0 result seconds, they should hold that lead as well. But it will be difficult as drizzle starts to fall just before the start of the race. And that will mean a slick, high-speed Assen track. Tim Joensen again on pole position ahead of Jan Lammers in their 2 Superlights. Then Henk Tace and Henry Zumbrink, and Pedro Salvador lining up 7th on the row behind Martin Lanting's Ferrari and Rob Campos in the Wolf GB08. So the yellow car, Jan Lammers, the red and white, Tim Joensen. Slippery conditions, cold tyres, this could be very tricky indeed. And away we go. The GT cars might have the better deal here. They've got more weight. And Henry Zumbrink again looking to try and go between the front row men. This time it's Tim Joensen who takes the lead from Jan Lammers. And Pedro Salvador going around the outside in the Mosler gets onto the curbs. He had got around the Ferrari, trying to get around the Rapax as well. Didn't grab that position from Henk Tace. So that's 5th from 7th on the grid for the Mosler driver. Henk Tace in 4th, Henry Zumbrink in 3rd. And it is Tim Joensen and Jan Lammers, the 2 prototypes that lead the field in the slippery conditions. Bob Herber also moving up the order. Martin Lanting's Ferrari dropping back down. And Roger Graz has taken the lead in GTB at Strubben, just like he did in race 1. Bob Herber alongside and shoots by 3rd in Super GT as they get down to the chicane. The black car on the inside, that's Kubokarts, taking second in GTB from teammate Chris Matthews as Marcel van Berlo and Art Bosman both overshoot their braking points and come back on pretty much where they left the track. Wet tyres are out, but nobody's called in for them yet. Jan Lammers still in second place, holding off Henry Zumbrink. Kua cars behind, led by Henk Tate. At the tail is Rob Campus and the Wolf. Oh, and somebody's hit a tyre stack. Now, was that him or was that the Ferrari? Either way, should cause some damage. Henry Zumbrink goes through past Jan Lammers, up into second place, leading in Super GT. Take a look again from on board the Volvo. Into the get, Timo Chicane, and watch Jan Lammers in a little deep, trying to get on the power. Little writhe as the tail slides around and the wheels spin. Through goes the Volvo. Lammers seems to be struggling a little bit for grip at the chicane. Henk Tase is right behind him, looking down to the inside into the first corner. That's an identical move to the one that the Volvo pulled. Henk Tase up to third overall. Lammers down to fourth, still second in class. Spinner, that's Hans Fabry in the team Race Art Porsche. Well, he was battling with a Turkish guest driver, Cengiz Oguzhan. Down into the corner, contact, and that's at Harbot. Spreads the field far and wide behind in avoidance. Back with the battle for second place. Henry Zumbrink in the grey and white Volvo. Behind red and silver, that is Henk Tase, the 72-year-old who just had a great race in race one. And Jan Lammers, the veteran Le Mans winner in the low-slung Ligier LMP3 car, bumps his way through on the inside. Henk Tase is made of sterner stuff. One of the few men currently racing who is older than Jan Lammers. Still drizzling, and that makes traction a little hard to come by for the big powerful rear engine cars, whether it's a prototype or these Super GTs. On board with Pedro Salvador, a little further back, problem, and that is him. And Dave and Dokerslot, spin for him. Little worried faces in the pit lane. He comes in reporting a puncture. So will they go for slicks or wets? Looks like it's only one tire. They have got a slick ready.
A tire just blew up, so I spun, of course, did halfway of the truck really slowly, changed the tire, so basically it all ended there. We will go until the end, collect some points still, but definitely not the target that we had for today.
Something's got the attention of the crowd on the start-finish straight. It's another crash. Temyosun, the race leader, and the Turkish driver, Cengiz Oguzhan. They both look okay, though.
Here op de eerste plek, ik denk 13, 14 seconden voor op de tweede.
I was leading the race with a 14-second lead, says a shaken Temyosun. Car was just amazing, and I was coming up to the point where I was going to be lapping the back markers. So I already knew that I had to be cautious. They can't always see the low sports cars like ours. So I've been very careful. Coming onto the start-finish straight, Porsche and the Radical, they stayed on the right-hand side, so I knew I could pass on the left. Soon as I got close, though, the two cars collided. The Porsche spun right across in front of me. Both went off. I crashed hard into the wall. I guess I was in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was a big hit. The safety car stayed out to the pit stop window. After the stops, Henry Zumbrink's Volvo led Super GT, Henk Tase right behind, with former teammates Martin Lanting and Bob Herbert third and fourth in their different cars. Henry Zumbrink chasing the Ligier, and a narrow squeeze there as Henk Tase dives up the inside, through in Strubben and up into second place. Now they're about to put a lap on Alberto Di Martin, and a little narrow miss again there for Tase with the Mosler driver. Zumbrink manages to make it through without too much drama. Davy Tech team, Henry Zumbrink's crew watching the screens. It's a great battle here. Henk Tase squeezes up the inside and has to take to the grass with all four wheels to get by the Mosler, who did not know he was coming. Henry Zumbrink continues to pile the pressure on the race leader, Henk Tase, in the Pumax RT ahead of the Volvo S60 V8. The checkered flag awaits at the end of the lap. Can the Davy Tech engineering driver get back in front, or will this be a monster weekend? He's got a run going, but Henk Tase has just enough in the tank to cover that. Zumbrink will have to go the long way round unless the back marker gets in the way at the chicane for the final time. They fly up towards the end of the lap. And drifting out wide, Henk Thijs. Tidier line from Henry Tumbrink, but Thijs has got the get. Timmy Chicane blocked. He will drag race Henry Tumbrink to the line. And it's going to be close, but it is victory for Henk Thijs. His second win of the weekend by 0.07 of a second.
Dit wil je altijd meemaken op zo'n dag.
This is what I've been dreaming of, to win such a race at such a big event in front of such a big crowd, and not to cruise the finish line, but to be in such an intense fight with Henry Tumbrink right at the limit. Not once did we hit each other. He just made one tiny mistake exactly at the moment where I could overtake him. I gave everything I've got, and you know, I wanted to win this race for all the people. For the guys who kept believing in me, working night and day on the car, that's what kept me going. Right, that's it now. A huge reception from the huge crowd for the hugely emotional double race winner, Henk Thijs. Rightly so. Martin Lansing and Bob Herbert finished in third and fourth. Henry Tumbrink took second. But Henk Thijs enjoying a weekend at Assen that he will probably never forget. Two race wins. Just remarkable. And that big hatful of points he's garnered moves him up to fourth in the Super GT title, closing on Henry Tumbrink as Alberto Di Martin and Pedro Salvador, who finished sixth in the first race, continue to lead by 3 points. After the pit stops, the battle for the lead in Superlights came down to the two Ligier LMP3s. Fritz van Aert came out ahead of Nigel Melker. In the first race, Melker passed him to take victory at the line, but then had a penalty, and that meant that Lammers and Van Aert won. However, this time there were no penalties to worry about, and some super quick lappery from Nigel Melker put him in front. Second place went to Jan Lammers and Fritz Van Aert, with Rob Campus and Leon Rijnbeck in third, joined by Mika Häkkinen on the podium.
Ja, ik ben super blij. Ik bedoel, eindelijk stoppen we in de auto.
Really happy with the result, said Nigel Melker. It's been a while since the last time I raced. To do so well this weekend has been awesome. Last lap I managed to pass Fritz van Aert, so very happy with the race. Dominic Jerkes won the second race of the weekend as well. Fiona James again in the runner-up position. In GTB, Mark van der Aar with the black BMW M4 Silhouette took the lead after the pit stops, but would soon lose it to Roger Graals in the Porsche, who's ahead of Vard Slice in the white BMW M4. Graals was last year's Super GT champion, and Vard Slice the runner-up in GTB. He's all over the back of the Porsche driver, looking for the lead in the GTB class once more. And down into the gate, Timmy Chicane slices inside Roger Graals. He and Chris Matthews go on to win their fifth race of the season, a double race win in Assen in GTB as in Super GT, with Roger Graals taking second ahead of Koen Bogaert and Mark van der Aar.
Oh, I'm super tevreden. Tweede plek is eigenlijk wel.
Really satisfied with second place, says Roger Graals. Of course, I aim for the win, and I got very close as well. But the BMW, Vard Slice, Chris Matthews, just too quick for my car. That's right, isn't it? You always blame the car, not the driver. No major changes at the top of the GTB Championship. Vard Slice, Chris Matthews looking very good indeed ahead of Art Bosman and Roger Graals. And that is it for Assen. Next time out will be at Snetterton in Norfolk, the first outing of the Supercar Challenge at the famous UK venue. We'll see you then, and until then, goodbye for now and thanks for watching. The Supercar Challenge is powered by Pirelli, Autosportinsurance.com, Syntix Innovative Lubricants, Magler, create your own digital magazine, and Valero, FIA approved race and rally base layers.